but nobody likes this scheme. People dislike this scheme. So whenever there is a scheme in law, alternative scheme, people should go for it, yes or no? But nobody liked the scheme. Therefore, very few people, took it, but very few people took the scheme. Right now, the scheme is really beneficial. I strongly advise, yesterday also I went to one Kerala shop in this Bhairavar. My article wanted some pickles and all. Alright, and he likes that Kerala pickles only. So we went there to buy that pickle. And that guy, because he knows that I'm chartered accountant, he asked me certain query. Alright, should I go for registration under GST or not? This is a question he asked. I told him, don't go. Because if you registered under GST, so much of compliance burden is there. This is my first answer. Then I asked, your turnover is exceeding 40 lakh or not? He said, no. Technically, even if it is exceeded, they are because shopkeepers, they don't account everything, no? So his accounting turnover is not exceeded 40 lakh. I said, as per GST law, you are not required to take a registration. But then he said, if I don't take a registration, I will not get input tax credit. I said, it's okay, no, don't take input tax credit. You don't have to pay tax. Hello? Alright. But then still he was insisting, what if I wanted a registration? I said, okay, you take a registration, but go for composition scheme. If you want a registration, then go for composition scheme. Then your compliance will be at least reduced. Okay. How reduced, sir? I told you, normal SSE files 3 returns every month. Pay the tax before 20th of following month, every month. Yes or no? Payment of tax has to happen before 20th. Composition dealer, beautifully they have written now, composition dealer needs to file only one return for whole year, and that is GSTR4. Which return composition dealer? Because 1, 2, 3 is already occupied for normal dealer, no?
Yes.
Outward supply 10th, inward supply 15th, and final return, 20. Monthly return is
20th.
That is GSTR 1, 2, 3. GSTR 4 is for composition dealer. Earlier, what happens earlier? Okay, earlier it was quarterly. Right now it is annual. Okay, latest amendment, 2018 amendment, composition dealer needs to file annual return once in a year. When, sir? From whole data, April to March, he will put on 30th April of next financial year. Due date is 30th April of next financial year. Can you keep due date in mind?
Yes.
Yeah? This is filing of return. Filing of return means giving his data to government. This much sales I have made, this much purchase I have made, that data he has to upload, and that in summary form, not in detail form. Okay? So that is his sales return, purchase return. Secondly, he need to pay tax quarterly. Composition dealer will pay tax. See, payment of tax is another thing and filing of return is another thing. There are two compliance that we do with any department. Payment of tax is different and filing of return is different. In income tax also, we pay tax through TDS, advance tax and self-assessment tax. Payment of tax is a different activity and then we file return. Yes or no? Alright, similarly here we pay GST and then we file return. Filing of return is a compliance thing, payment of tax is your obligation. Okay? Alright, he has to pay tax quarterly. Quarterly means, you understand? What is the first quarter of the year? April, May and June. We always follow financial year. April, May and June, whatever sales you are going to do, you have to put that composition rate, maybe 1% or 5%, alright, and that tax you need to pay before 18th of the next month, 18th of the next month, so 18th, hello, see, 10, 15 and 20, these dates are already taken, so some other date they wanted, because CAs cannot do all work on the same day, no, server, they have to allocate server on different day, therefore these dates are kept like this. Hello?
Yes.
Server should be free. If they can put composition dealer also due date as 20th, but then what will happen? Again, what problem will happen? Whole India, normal dealer as well as composition dealer, both will log into the system on the same day. And then system will crash, CAs are in burden, articles are in burden, cost accountants are in burden. So now the date for composition dealer is 18th.
Yes.
So we have to pay tax on 18th of following month. After end of the quarter, so what is the first quarter? April, May, June. So due date will be 18th
July.
Then second quarter?
July,
August, September. 18th October. October, November, December. 18th January. Jan, Feb, March. 18th April. And then whole year data, you put it into 30th April. Am I clear with this? Yeah? Okay. Return, only one return, 4 payments. one return, four payments. Normal dealer, three returns, 12 payments. Monthly, no? Normal. So which option is better?
Composition
dealer. But problem with composition dealer is this, and their rate of tax is very low.
Yes.
For manufacturer, it is 0.5% CGST and 0.5% AGST on total supply. Okay, total aggregate supply. For restaurant, 2.5% and 2.5% on total supply. And for traders who are not manufacturers, shopkeepers and all, they don't manufacture. They just buy commodities and they sell commodities. For them, 0.5 on taxable supply. So that is a different, that I will explain you now. But rates are very low, no? 0.5. Look at the normal rates. 9.9, 14.14, 6.6. Hello? So there are rates like 5%, 12%, 18%, 28% GST. And these people are paying only 0.5. Almost negligible. Very low GST rate, yes or no?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Alright? So, you are the deal, you are the buyer, you tell me. There are two shops. Okay? One is normal dealer shop. And one is composition dealer shop. Where will you go and buy? If you go here, they will charge 18% GST. On sale value, 18%. And here if you go, they will charge 1%. In which shop you will go? Obviously, you will go to composition shop, no? Because there is a low GST. But I will never go to this shop, composition shop. I will not go to composition dealer shop. Why? I will always go to 18% shop. Why? Because I do transaction in B2B service and you do transaction B2C. And what is the advantage to B2B people? B2B people can take ITC and B2C people cannot take ITC. So if you don't want ITC, it is advisable for you to take goods from composition dealer. Hello? Alright. But if you need ITC, we should never take goods from composition dealer. Alright. So dealer who is doing major transaction in B2C. Direct business to consumer. That means the retailer level. You understand that supply chain management?
Yes.
Manufacturer, wholesaler, distributor, then retailer. Then retailers may go into composition scheme. But behind that, okay, all previous stages, they should usually not go into composition, because if you are going into composition, you are going to break the supply chain.
Yes.
Hello, this credit chain will be broken, because composition dealer have this particular sad song in his heart. Always he feel this regret. Nami credit le paunga, nami credit de paunga. I cannot take credit, I cannot give credit. We don't allow any credit to composition dealer. Why? Because if you allow credit, his credit will be of 18% and 28%. Are you getting this?
Yes.
His credit will be 18%, 20% and his output liability is only 1%.
Yes.
He will never pay tax. That's not the purpose of law, no? So what we have done? We are not allowing him any ITC. You cannot take any ITC, sir. You just pay 1% tax from your pocket. Hello?
Yes.
Alright. And this 1% tax paid is not allowed as a credit to your buyer. So, nami credit le paunga, nami credit de paunga. Therefore, composition dealer can never issue tax invoice. Hello? To take credit, you need to have one document, and that document is tax invoice. Composition dealer can never issue a document called tax invoice. But he has to issue some document. No, without document, you cannot release the goods. So he issued bill of supply. He is going to issue what?
Bill
of supply. Am I clear?
Yes.
So composition dealer cannot issue document called tax invoice. He has to issue bill of supply. On top of the bill of supply, it has to be written. This dealer is a composition dealer and ITC cannot be availed. It is mandatory that to mention these words on invoice. And not only invoice, he has to write that on the nameplate of his business. So if you go to some restaurant, specifically Shiv Sagar and all, if you go there, you can see one board is there on counter, okay, composition dealer. It has to be written there as a composition dealer. Why? Because a buyer should know whether the dealer is a composition dealer or normal dealer. If the board written composition, obviously I am telling you, I will not enter into that shop. Why? Because I know this guy cannot issue me ITC. Are you getting this? Sure? Pakka? Hello? Can I go ahead with this?
Yes.
So this is the composition scheme. Now composition scheme you can avail only if you are a small dealer. Only if you are a
small dealer.
Now whether you are a small or big dealer cannot be judged by looking your current year turnover. Current year is started today, 1st April. Today is the 1st April. I wanted to check whether in current year I am going to be a composition dealer or a normal dealer. Alright. So I cannot talk about current year turnover because current year is just started today. Morning. Okay. We are doing puja, open our office 1st April. Now I am thinking I should apply for composition scheme or normal scheme. Hello? Because composition scheme is not by default available. You have to make application for it. It's a special scheme. It's an alternative scheme. Hello? Are you getting this?
Yes.
So government say, when you are going to apply for composition scheme, please look at your last year turnover. Not in current year turnover. Please look at your last year turnover. If your last year turnover is up to 1.5 crore, that means not exceeding 1.5 crore. Yes or no?
Yes.
If your last year turnover is up to 1.5 crore, then you are a small dealer, you can go for composition. If your turnover exceeds 1.5 crore, Saab, you are a big trader, you can hire one cost accountant or chartered accountant. Or in worst case, you can at least hire GST consultant. Hello? Who will look after your matters. But if your turnover is 20 lakh, 25 lakh in a year, you are a very small guy. You don't have to go for chartered accountant and three times in a year, three times in a month, 36 times in a year. It's a compliance, we also understand it is very difficult for you to maintain documents and records and filing of return and payment of tax on a duly, timely basis. Yes or no?
Yes.
Therefore, you can go for compliance. If you are turning 2 crore, 5 crore, 10 crore, 50 crore, 100 crore, so obviously don't come for composition, then go for normal scheme. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Hello? Therefore, this turnover criteria is there that you should not come into composition. Am I clear? Big dealer should not come into composition, only small dealer should come into composition. Are we clear about this?
Yes.
Next is, there are certain states in India which are called as special states.
Yes.
Okay? Technically, they are northeast, north and northeastern states. Alright? That Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Tripura, Sikkim. Alright? So all these are there, okay? Out of these 11 special states that we are having in GST law, there are total 11, okay? Three have opted this higher limit. Three have opted this higher limit. Which are those three? Assam, Himachal Pradesh, and Jammu and Kashmir. This is latest amendment. Assam, Himachal Pradesh, and Jammu and Kashmir, and rest of India. Rest of India means balance India. Kerala, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal.
Yes.
Hello? All states, because GST is a state based law, no?
Yes.
All states have opted for 1.5 crore limit. Because these other states, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, and all, Nagaland, they don't have that much turnover capacity. See, because their economy is little low, consumption is little low. So they said if you put 1.5 crore as the limit, majority of state will get covered. And then we will not have any proper revenue from the GST system. So they have reduced the limit to 75 lakh. So their limit is 75 lakh. So 8 states out of all states in India are having 75 lakh rupee limit. And Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, and rest of India is having 1.5 crore as a limit, aggregate turnover. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah? So this is how they are. Then we have to define what is aggregate turnover. So aggregate turnover means total turnover. Turnover means credit side of P&L account. Alright. That includes your taxable supply, interstate supply, that includes your exempt supply, export supply, everything is there. Alright. But it should not include any GST component or inward supply on which you are supposed to pay tax on reverse charge basis. So these conditions are also there. Am I clear? Alright. So this is a composition scheme that we are going to discuss. Very important scheme from examination perspective. Second issue is with me this. Latest amendments are not captured by CMA module. So I would like to teach this particular concept from ICA latest module. Otherwise there will be mismanagement of questions. Okay? Sure? Yeah? So we will continue composition scheme.